Hello, Gil here with the Sailing Vessel Last Affair, and today we're going to do a short video on how to service the Barient winches on this particular boat. On our Gulfstar, we have three Barient 21s and two Barient 28s as our primaries. We'll start with the 28s. They're really in pretty rough shape behind me. They're the primaries. We'll start with those, and I'll show you a little trick that we use to make sure that we don't drop some of the parts overboard when we pull these apart. Hope it's helpful. Thanks.
Okay, we're taking a view straight down of the winch, and you can see this is a self-tailing winch, so we need to loosen up these four Allen nuts on this particular one to go ahead and take this piece off. This is a great time to show what I've done here. This works really well with a pail or a bucket. In this particular case, I use the bottom of a flower pot. But you take and you cut it out so that the hole in the bottom is just the size of the base of the winch. In our case, I made it a little bit big. But the nice thing is if you drop something, they fall right down into that cover. I always keep a little pail handy just to keep all our screws and whatnot in. And then we have to take this fitting off here. The internet's great. I saw this online somewhere. Put in a winch handle, put the screw into one of these holes, an old one that you're not going to worry about, and then just push and it'll slowly rotate that around. It's actually loosening that up. And I'll come around to this side and keep going. That should be loose now. Should be able to just rotate this around now. Yep. Got the cap nut off. I'm just using a little screwdriver to loosen this up a little bit. I don't know how long it's been since these have been serviced. This is the first time we're servicing them on this boat. It could be ugly. My biggest fear is just making sure I don't drop it overboard. Same with the self-tailing portion. Put that down there. So now, the next step here is to remove this winch off the base, but I want to be careful that I don't pull the bearings up and off of here. So, do this very slowly and carefully. Here's just another view of this. Again, we're taking the self-tailing portion off, and then what we want to do is we want to lift this winch up off the base, but we have to be really careful we don't have the bearings slide out with it. So we'll carefully go up, and I'm looking inside to make sure they're not coming up. They're not. You can see here, nice and clear inside there, and our bearings are still on the shaft. I'm going to go ahead and take these bearings off, and again, these needle bearings just kind of slide right up off of there. Just be careful you don't drop anything in the water. Well, there's two sets of those on these Barient 28s. Good news is they look like they're in pretty good shape, other than being a little bit gummy. Well, we'll be able to clean those right up. So I'm hoping you can see this. We used a little engine degreaser, and these were the two that were really stuck yesterday. So it's been a full 24 hours. Been working these things just a little bit at a time. The good news is they are both free. And happy to report, did not break. So after soaking this with penetrating oil for several days now, it still isn't coming loose. I put a note out on Cruisers Forum to see if people had any suggestions, and there were a couple of them. One of them was to try using a thin putty knife instead of the screwdriver and try to tap that out of there in hopes to get that corrosion down to the base. So we'll give that a shot. This does appear to be making at least a dent in it. Let's see if this continues as I go around it. Now pull it out and do it again.
Okay, we're going to try another little crazy thing here. I was unable to get this off just by tapping it and getting the corrosion out with a putty knife. So I'm going to apply some pressure here. I have a line tied to a cleat, wrapped around the base, and then go in here to my secondary, and we'll see if we can't put enough pressure on this thing to potentially break that loose. And obviously, you want to be really careful. I'm going to do it this direction so that if something were to break loose, the winch comes inbound and not outbound. You ready, Deb?
Okay.
Hold on, let's let loose a minute. It made a noise like something broke loose a little bit. Cruiser Forum, you're the best in the world.
Happy dance, it worked.
This is when cruiserforum.com has been an invaluable asset. I was not able to get the winch off this boat. It was corroded to the aluminum base. I posted out on Cruiser Forum, and I received a couple of suggestions. One person suggested using a small, thin putty knife and working around between the aluminum base and the bronze winch itself, and trying to get the corrosion out, which I did. The next step was I still couldn't budge it. So another person actually posted a really genius idea. They said, why don't you take a line, tie it off to a cleat, wrap it around that winch, and apply pressure in hopes that you can break it loose from the base. Just be very careful you don't have it go overboard. So I want to show you the inside of this base. Take a look here. So you can see in this base, it's probably been years since this thing has been serviced. It's horrendous. This is dirt and grease just mixed. So I'll get this all cleaned out, and I'll see if this base is salvageable. We'll take a look at this. It's not good if I have to replace this, but I'll tell you what, I'd rather replace this base than have to replace that entire primary. So let's see what we get after I get this cleaned up. And clearly this thing hasn't been serviced. Nobody put any kind of Lanacote or protective material on it. And as most of you know, dissimilar metals in a saltwater environment begin to corrode. So we had an aluminum base and a bronze top. And well, thankfully the aluminum is what, you know, is the lesser of the two metals. So it corroded first.
The second step is like we're going to try to remove this base. We noticed all the screws were corroded, so it's going to be hard to take the base off.
Very good.
So we have the drum off, which is great news. And there's essentially three screws on the bottom side that hold this retaining plate on where the gears are held. There's also a nut right here, a retaining screw, that we'll take off to take a little cap off, but we won't do that yet. So these three are the ones we have to get to. I put a little bit of penetrating oil, sprayed a little bit on these earlier to break them loose. In my case, I have a bucket that I'm keeping the drum in, and I have also a small bucket where I have all the larger bearings and whatnot that we had from earlier in this video. I'll hang on to those as well. I have a small bin here where I put the bearings in, and I used the back of a screwdriver to scrape the heavy stuff off and let them soak in this. This happens to be kerosene. You can use diesel or paint thinner or whatever cleaning substance you like best. And then you just want to run up and down on the needle bearings while rotating your fingers on the inside so you're cleaning all sides of those.
Don't forget to take off the paws and don't lose the springs.
Very good. That's good advice, Chastity.
Thank you.
So you just want to clean these right in here in some kerosene or diesel. I just let them soak for a while after using a screwdriver to scrape off some of the really heavy stuff, and then just use the brush to clean them all out. This will ensure you get all the built-up grease from the previous servicing off. Or in the case of this one, these have been neglected for many, many, many years. It's a bit of a tricky part right here. These are pawls, and inside they're springs. These should move. They should have that motion. You want them to spring back just like that, very easily. The way these work is they fit inside of these gears. The purpose for the pawls are to allow this to only rotate in one direction. So you can see here how that works. And then if you try to go the other way, those pawls jump right in and grab it. And to check them, you want to make sure that they fit and seat nicely in those grooves. You can see that See how nicely that fits right into that groove there? And it's doing the same on the other side. That means that those pawls are in good shape and don't have to be replaced at this point. Frankly, the springs seem like they're okay too, but I am going to take these off and get them cleaned up. I know some of you are watching this video thinking, man, this is an awful lot of work, but this shouldn't be as bad for yours if they have been serviced on a fairly regular basis. These have been neglected for, I'm afraid, many, many, many years. When I'm done, I like to lay out all my parts, make sure I have everything I need. You can see here I've got kind of everything laid out. It's also good to have the schematic so you know how you're going to put it all back together. And I have some new grease for the gears, some oil for the springs, and some new springs. Okay, we're going to replace the Paul springs. The way we do this is we just buy these Paul springs at West Marine. It was $20 or something for 10 of them, so well worth it. Get this a little bit loose, start lifting it up. Before it gets halfway up, we get our thumb in place. We can hold that spring. We let loose. We take the spring out. We get the new spring. Put the flat edge along the pawl. And then just like we took it out, we're going to reverse it. We'll put the round barrel end in this opening. Once the slot goes below the base, we can let go with our thumb. Oh, I let go a little too soon, as you can see. Do that again. Hold that piece in. Put this right down below the base. Once it's down there, we can let go, push it all the way in, and our spring's in place. One thing we don't want to do is grease these pawls because the grease is sticky, so we get a little bit of this this winch oil. It's just a lightweight or graphite oil, I'm not sure. But I'm only putting 2 drops of it in there. And then pushing this in and working it back and forth a little bit. And you can see, even before where this one was sticking, these are much better now. So the easiest way to do this is if you just pinch these down, and then if you rotate it in the direction that they would fold down while you insert it into the gear, they'll go right in. Reassemble this. We got some of the winch grease. We actually don't need a lot of this. I'm just going to put a small amount on this particular shaft, and I've also put a small amount on the bearings. I'm going to slide those down onto the shaft. I'll slide this shaft into the drum, and I have another set of bearings here. We're going to do a small amount of grease on the inside of these, and also on the outside of those bearings. And these should not be tough to put in. We're just going to push them right on in there. Okay. Next step is we're going to put this large washer on. One thing you don't want to do is put grease anywhere near this part. We don't want to chance this getting caked with grease. Inside this spindle from the top side so it doesn't get on it when I slide this down over the assembly. You want to hold these two pieces together because these splines need to line up and slide it right down. We'll now put a spacer in here. My hands are greasy. And we'll just finger tighten this particular screw. We're now going to do the same thing with the next assembly here. I'm just going to take some of the grease. I'm going to just force some of it right down onto these bearings. Not a whole lot, just enough to keep them lubed up. And we're going to slide that right over the top of this particular shaft. And then same with this particular gear. We're going to slide this over the top of this. Add just a small amount of grease here. There's already some on the bearings. We'll add just a little bit more. And one thing a lot of people do is they over-grease these bearings. We just don't need to do that. All it's going to do is get all the sand and dust that's in the air and get them caked into this. We'll repeat the same process. We have another medium-sized bearing. We're going to slide some grease into the bearing itself. Put that down over this particular shaft. And just like before, I want to be careful that I don't get grease on these pawls. So I'm going to grease this from the other side, so it's not going to push it up into it. We're going to slide this down. And again, you'll have to rotate these gears just a little bit because they need to mesh with each other in order to slide all the way down. I wanted to show this because this particular idler gear here can go in one of either way. There's a small lip on one side. The lip goes up, which is aiming down right now because this is upside down. So this whole top piece from the pawls in the inner gear to the outer gear should all be flush. If you put it the other way and this is raised along this outer lip, when you put this particular washer on, what's going to happen is the metal plate is going to put too much pressure on it. So it's really important that when you put this particular gear on, that flat side is the one that goes along the washer on the bottom side. Now, this next piece is interesting. I've got to put grease on this bearing, but I don't want to get any on those particular pawls. So I'm just only going to squeeze some grease between these, between the needle bearings. And I'm not going to put an excessive amount there. I'm letting some of it actually go all the way through. Now, we'll just slide this down into this particular opening. And I have a paper towel here to wipe up any of that grease that might have oozed up out of that, because I don't want that to get on those particular pawls. Okay. Step is closing that. And now we're going to grease the final... this is a slightly larger bearing than those four medium-sized ones, but not as big as the drum bearing. Take that one, grease it up, put it right on the top of this whole unit. And then I'm going to put just a bit of grease in the base of this particular piece, too, which is where that seats in. Maybe, just maybe, if I add a little bit of grease into these openings, it'll make this slide on a little easier. One can hope. A matter of pressing this on, and I'll use a hammer and tap it on. It's probably the easiest way to do it. Before you get it all the way in there, don't forget this little spacer that has to go right in between these two gears where there's a screw hole in the bottom and a pin in the top. This should now turn nice and smooth, and it does. We're back on the boat, and what we're going to do is start to put this together, and we want to make sure we don't run into the same corrosion problem we had before. So I'm using some of this Lanacoat from Spar. This is a rust and corrosion protector that you put between dissimilar metals, and it helps prevent galvanic corrosion. So I'm just going to kind of dip this in there, get a little bit on there, wipe off some of the excess, and insert it down into this hole. And I'm going to do that with each of the screws here. So that they're completely coated. If you're wondering, this stuff smells nasty. Now once you have all the screws tightened and the Lanacoat on it, and still turning nice and smoothly, we're going to go ahead and put this base in. Now, it's important to note when you first took it out what direction these gears were. I don't know that it really matters, but I'm going to make sure I put it in the same way. So it's just a matter of lining up the screw holes right into the base. And actually, before I do that, I'm going to smear a little Lanacoat right down on the surface between those two. Between those two surfaces. There's probably a better way of doing this than by hand, but that's what I'm doing. And I'm just putting this around the base, anywhere that the aluminum is going to make contact with that bronze. I'm using this a little bit liberally, probably more than I need to, but I figure this is a $10 tube of Lanacoat, and this is a very expensive winch, so I'd rather waste a few bucks on the Lanacoat. Just kind of show what this looks like when it's in there. You can see where I just line this up on any of those spots where the base actually touches it. Again, here's a close-up. You can actually see where the corrosion is around this ring of this one. It started to actually eat away the aluminum from that corrosion. There's a view with the Lanacoat, the brown substance smeared on it.
Now that I've got each of those just started finger tight, we're going to go ahead and tighten them up. And just like it before, we're going to do this a lot like the wheels on a hub. We're going to rotate around and not crank down one side real hard before the others are done.
Now that we have the base, or the winch mounted into the base, we're now going to put the spindle bearings or needle bearings on the shaft. So, just like before, just a little bit bigger now, we're going to put grease on this, and you want to push it down inside the needles, but you don't want this thing to be so caked that it gets gummy. I think that should be more than enough. We'll put just a little bit around the shaft. And we'll do the same with this other one. Next step now is to go ahead and slide the drum right down on here, and pretty simple, it just slides on without any real effort. Just make sure you don't bend any of the bearings when you slide it on there. Get it lined up nice and smooth, and on she goes. These splines are going to line up on the top of the drum, and it's important that we get these screw holes lined up where we want, and they have to match the screw holes on this. So, put this in place. This piece down, and it's just a matter now of screwing the rope clutch to this top piece, and now this piece fits right on top here. As I showed when we were taking this apart, the easiest way to tighten this up, once we get it just finger tight, is to put a little screw in that hole there, and then use a winch handle, and just bear down on the screw itself. There we go. And then it's just a matter of tightening it up against that. We'll do the same thing on this side. And that is a beautiful thing, because that winch is turning freely, and before, it almost didn't turn. That's a good sound. I'm so excited to be able to just do this, because it has been a long time since I could. That is beautimous. Well, that wraps it up, folks. I hope you found this video useful, and I hope it becomes a good reference for you if you need to rebuild your Barient 28 two-speed.